expectation from the Gettlewood fan, but it was to Norville as Sean Forbes coming with the rebound. Shoots from downtown is Powell. Rebound by Fifield. He runs away from the chasing double. He could go all the way. He does and lays it up and misses. Easily up goes Spanish. Chip from low. Good clean defense by the Heaters team as Marlon Powell. He fades to, gets the ball court to double, double pass to White. White face up goes and gets an easy basket. Traveling foul by the referee, Ian Hanley. And good referee here tonight. Ian Hanley not leaning anywhere. See Hanley advancing without putting the ball at the top. And issuing a traveling foul to the Gettlewood team. As Spanish, beyond the 3-point line, shoots. And it's good. The first 3-pointer for this Gettlewood tonight. Tying the score. For all with 8 minutes and 9 seconds to go in this all-important first half. Trevor Marty hugging the ball. Give it to his fellow guard, Marlon Powell. He misses off the front of the rim. Rebound by Spanish. Give it to Brown. Brown to the Black Mamba, who could go all the way. He does. He has it off to Charlie Watley. Watley, the left hand layup, trying tremendous around of applause as the foot up. The Gettlewoods continues here tonight. The Gettlewoods seem to have a bigger, larger support for Dan Heaters in this arena tonight. Sean Fox from Dunton again, shoot, misses. Big rebound there by Charlie Watley. Hand it off to Brown. Brown bounces, quasi half foot. Hand off to the Black Mamba number 8. He's been blocked there by Shabba Fox and is indicated by referee Ian Leibold with Fox not liking the foul, but the Gettlewoods team having a chance to retreat the strategy that Heaters call for a timeout, a breather, as they now see that the Gettlewood team has come from behind and now has led some 6 points to 4 and could have a chance to extend the lead as they have the ball from the side, or we have not seen indication from referee Ian will be shot. As you see coach Glenn Goth Phillips demonstrated to Buzz White, he should block out or probably play more defensive role, as you see Marlon Skywalker Davis entering the fray of things, being number 7 on his chest. No, he goes back to the bench as they get the Heaters team before to remain with their team that they had on the court before. Try Watley with the ball. Bounce pass to number 7. Out to Brown. Brown cross to the Black Mambo. But pass to poor pass. Perfect bad pass, as we say in football term. Deshaun Favre was the Black Mamba at the time. Turn over to Heaters. From downtown, we have Trevor Matthew missing. Big rebound by Spanish. Spanish have a great leaping ability. Bounce pass out to Levi Fifey, who could go all the way. The ball with tip. Up goes Bally Brown from the rebound. After Sean Fabler intercepted the pass and scores, so it's now 8-4. Doubling the score in this Gettlewood team. And we have a blocking foul there. Yes, by the Gettlewoods. Spanish playing quite good game tonight, but Marlon Powell was on the way to the basket and he was impeded in his way, and referee Ian Leibold blew what he thought was an infringement, and it will be an inbound pass to the Rams Heaters tonight. Quite a packed stadium, and it continues to go as the lob pass being picked up by Fifey. He could go all the way. Yes, perfect bad pass again, as he was not thinking on that occasion. He tries to rush the pass. Pick off pass by Levin Taylor. Send it off to bye-bye Fifey. Bay number 8 in his back. Bounces. Restart the offense for Gettlewood. After Brown. Brown takes it in from the crossover. Shoots from downtown. And it's good. He stands up with an air of simplicity and say what some easy things. 10-4 in favor of this Gettlewood team. With Marlon Powell shooting from downtown. And it's good. Sending a message to this Gettlewood team that if you don't mark me, I'm going to shoot out the lights tonight. So it's bye-bye with the ball. And after Rommel Brown. Brown takes his first move. Back to bye-bye. Bye-bye cross with the Taylor. Taylor puts on the mat. He could go all the way. He was fouled in the process of doing so by number 22, Sean Farb. And that is 2 on Farb with only 3 minutes and 52 seconds gone in the first half. We get the Woods leading 10-7. And no doubt we'll see a substitution from Heaters bench very, very soon. We only see one foul being shown. I thought that he had a foul earlier, but the scorer seems to say it's only one, as Taylor shoots his first free throw, and it goes in. So Gettlewood extend the lead now to some 4-point lead, as we see coach leaving his bench, as Taylor, Quincy Taylor, the brother of Levin Taylor, the cricketer, shoots the second free throw, and it's good, as Powell receives the ball from his defender. He goes from his teammates. Now he's trying to cross. He's defended heavily by Taylor. Lob pass cross to Trevor Matthews. Lob pass out to White. Touch pass to Shabba. Shabba cross score to Dowell. Dowell to Marlon. Marlon on the intense pressure. Powell being stripped there by ever-present Taylor. Now he bans with green position. And it's a poor pass. Picked up by Wommel Brown. Brown trying to get forward. And it's a tap pass there to the Ghetto Roots number 7. Taken all the way and in there by the team. But here, what referee Ian Lybert making a call that is quite disagreeable. Many of the fans here tonight saying offense against Quincy Taylor, and it is a call that they think that it hangs in the balance, so I won't reserve my comments for the next call. As you see, Marlon Powell passes the half court, love the pass over to Trevor Hardy into Sean Favre. Trevor put on the mat, love the cross to Huggins. Huggins fakes the shot in, bump pass to White. White out to Marlon Powell, behind the 3-point bench, dribbles inside, goes. Hand it off to a driving double. There goes the referee Ian Lybert, busy with his call tonight. He indicated a call on number 8 and number 23. But number 8, yes, is the Black Mamba. Guilty culprit on this time in Levi Bye-Bye Fifield. And he'll be giving up 2 free throws to the number 23, David Double. First trip to the free throw line tonight, and it's good. So he does cutting into this 5-point lead at the Ghetto Roots once in jar with 5 minutes and 21 seconds. It's now 12-8. It could be 9-12 by the end of this feature. Shoot. They say break. And yes, the fans get it more, but referee Ian Lybert saw that there was an infringement on the case of the Ghetto Roots players, and therefore he allowed this long man to shoot a second. And brick was a shot, but this time it was no brick, it was a conversion. So, much to the chagrin of the Ghetto supporters, it is now 9-12 with 5 minutes and 17 seconds. Bally Brown shoots from downtown, from the circus, misses. But right with a big rebound, hands off to Favre. Favre pulls up the rebound, hands it off to Marlon Powell, being number 44. Hands it off to Trevor Matthews, shoots a 3. Garbage, solid base, collected by Sean Favre, looking for a solid base, and good. So really collecting bonus, this good Sean Forbes working for the solid race in this game tonight. Cleanup man as Bally Brown cross court to number 8, 5 feet. 5 feet down to Spanish, pass into Watley. Watley gets around his man and up, and a very important basket, keeping the momentum for the Ghetto Woods team, scoring on almost every trip down in this half and really showing their confidence tonight. As Coach Garfield Alexander, they explained to me that they don't want to let hitters back in this for the third game. Cross court pass to Favre, bounce pass to Dowell. Bad shot collected by Watley, hands off to the Black Mamba. He's on his way and rejected the first in by number 23, Dowell. His timing was excellent and he swatted away like how we swat away flies and mosquitoes in St. Kitts. And that was definitely a wake up call for Levi by 5 feet. So inbound pass to the number 23 for hitters as they get animated. Goes, it's up, Glenn Jeffers, and the ref indicated yes, they are agreeing with Coach Glenn Goes Philip, and it's a bump pass to Eaters. Inbound to Powell, he's been guarded by Quincy Taylor. Love pass to Dowell. Dowell inside to 24, Favre to Powell. Powell fakes his pass, loved it over to Trevor Matthew Huggins, back to Powell. Powell cross to Dowell. Dowell shoots a 22 yard jumper up off the fingers of the veteran. Was right, but no, the referee said it was off of the Ghetto Woods team, and it's hit to the inbound about. So it's Marty Huggins off to White. White to encroaching Dowell. Dowell mishandled the ball, and it turned over, as the poetic justice will say, and it will be an inbound pass to the Ghetto Woods team. Ghetto Woods number 6 in the ball. Bally Brown hand it off to the Black man, but he fakes his shot, and the referee judged that he has traveled. And there we have an indication of a substitution for the Ghetto Woods team, for the Heaters team, big pardon. And we have the giant Marvin Skywalker coming into the fray. As you see, we have a timeout now being called by the Ghetto Woods team. So it's one timeout being called by each team so long. Seems to be some kind of hot-headedness or some kind of discrepancy creeping into the Ghetto Woods right up to